Good morning, everyone. When people take me for granted, oh, I'm sorry, I forgot I only existed when you need something. I feel a bit invisible and taken for granted, George. Oh, that's silly, Ethel. Why don't you make dinner for us and we'll talk about it? Hey, babe, glad you're home from work. Do you think you can run to the grocery store for more beer before the game starts? Taken for granted, what does it mean? To fail to appreciate something or someone. It means to give little attention to or to underestimate the value of something or someone, especially once it's gone. I hate it when people take me for granted. Haven't we all been there sometime, somewhere? Let's see what Dr. Ali has got to say regarding this.
Very good morning. You have not been taken for granted. But if you have, there are ways and means to overcome it. It's a normal thing. There are a lot of people who try to take advantage, who try to take you for granted. At the same time, during this hour, I would also like to help you to introspect and understand that sometimes we are taken for granted because of the way we behave also. So we will look into both aspects. That is, why is it that some people tend to take others for granted? You know, the slide that Sunita showed you just now, and she was telling you that you are taken for granted till you are needed for something. The husband who is happily relaxing and watching TV, when his wife comes back after putting in a hard day's work, he is telling her that, can you go and get me some more beer before the game starts? Now he is taking her for granted that he can get anything done from her. At the same time, he is using her. It's not even as though he's taking her for granted, saying, okay, she's no good and this and that, so forget it, and I will do what I want. No. When he needs that beer, he is without hesitation, without thinking twice, he is very casually, as though it's the most natural thing, to say, oh, good, you've come back from office, now run down and go and get me a bottle of beer. This is what happened. There are people like this, whether you like it or not. But the question comes, is this person, you know, taking everybody for granted? There are those type of people who say what we refer to, you know, in the TA language as, I am okay, you are not okay. I'm the only important person in this world. I'm the person who is right. I'm the person who is most important. And everybody else can be, you know, tools to help me improve my quality of life. So one is, you'll come across these type of people who take everybody for granted. They think that I'm the only important person in this whole world. And everybody is born only to serve me or fulfill my needs and stuff like that. When that happens, it's not a very personal thing. So at least you know that this guy takes everybody for granted, including me. But if you come across somebody who takes only you for granted, he's being nice to everybody. Now, that is a huge population. For example, this cartoon which Sunita showed you just now. This man may be, you know, lounging around doing nothing, wasting his time watching TV. But when he gets up and dresses up and goes out into the neighborhood or the society, probably he comes out as a very nice, very, you know, polite, a very helpful person. He builds up that image. And when he comes back home, he doesn't bat an eyelid to make his wife slog, not only in office, but at home and for all possible things to fulfill his needs and his desires. So when you find that there is a person who is not taking others for granted, but is taking you for granted, then you need to, you know, look into what has been my contribution to it. Then comes the next question. Who is this person who's taking me for granted? If it is somebody not very important to you, let's say you work in an organization and you have a few colleagues and all that, there's this one guy who hardly bothers even to wish you. He will just send off a mail to you or throw a paper on your table or whatever it is. And you know, he doesn't seem to give you any significance. You do a lot of work, and when you do something and give it, he doesn't even bother to acknowledge or, you know, say a word of thanks or anything of that sort. He just presumes, yeah, you were supposed to do it, you have done it, so what's so great about it? Now, in these sort of situations, it is easy to say, this guy doesn't appreciate, this guy doesn't acknowledge, this guy takes me for granted. So, if there is certain responsibility, if I have to do something, you know, which I have to do for him, as in, you know, we are part of the same family or the same organization or same neighborhood or anything of that sort, I will do that and full stop. I will not do anything more than that, beyond that. And it is easier also to maintain our own self-respect and self-worth by saying, something wrong with this guy, you know. He doesn't have basic courtesies. Probably his upbringing has been bad or his temperament is bad. So I'm going to just accept it it doesn't come on to me. Where it becomes very important is when you start taking it personally. What have I done to him? Where have I let him down? When I am doing so much for him, can he not at least reciprocate 10% of what I am doing? Every time I go out of the way to do things for this person. But even once in a while, if I need something from this person, I don't get it. And not only I don't get it, he doesn't even seem to think that he has to do it for me. He gets surprised. What? You want me to do that? Come on, yeah, get it done. Yeah, it's okay. You know, that sort of thing. Or when I am in need and I am asking him for something, he is taking me for granted and saying that, no, you can go ahead. Now, this cartoon which you saw. Supposing the wife is very tired or she's not well or she's on bed or something of that sort. This type of husband will probably say, okay, once you're finished with your resting, get up and go and do the cooking or get that beer bottle for me or something of that sort. He's not even turning around to see that probably she's not well or she's extremely tired or she's sick or something. So let me at least inquire, how are you and how come you're lying down when you normally don't lie down? That is how this person takes you for granted, saying that it is fine. Really doesn't bother me whether she's come back tired or whether she's lying down or whether she is sick. I need that beer bottle, so I'm just going to ask for it. And if she doesn't get it, I'm going to be quite surprised. Hey, what's wrong with you here? Why can't you do this much for me and things of that sort? So let us start by, looking inward first before we start analyzing what to do with others. Because as you are well aware, in life, you have to deal with a wide variety of people. You have to deal with good people, bad people. And the funny part is that you have to deal with a lot of people who do not come under the category of good or bad. Like I said, some of them may even be in the category where other people praise them. Oh, he is such a considerate person. He is so nice. He is so helpful. He is so polite. And that hits you very badly because you say that, am I doing something wrong? Why is he being bad to me? When he can be so nice and so helpful to others, why can't he do 10% of that to me? When these sort of questions and doubts start coming into your mind, that is when you start thinking. It's good. You should think. But before we even talk about thinking, let me caution you. If for any reason you are being taken for granted and that is leading to low self-esteem, feeling of worthlessness, feeling that maybe I am not good enough, maybe I have not treated this person correctly or something of that sort. If you are getting those type of feelings, I would like to caution you, first overcome that. Do not allow anybody to make you feel guilty. Guilt is a very destructive emotion. Guilt can take away your initiative. Guilt can make you feel miserable. Guilt can bring down your self-esteem. Guilt can spoil your other relationships, which normally would have been quite good. When all these things happen, you know that you need to come out of it. So before anything else, ensure that there is no lurking sense of guilt, shame, regret or something of that sort. Yes, we are going to analyze very rationally, very nominally, that if there has been a contribution from my side, if somewhere I have been found lacking, yes, I will work on it. But I'm not going to condemn myself and put myself down. So if you're okay with that, then let us start with understanding a very, very basic thing which many of us soft and docile people often ignore. And that is, in the world, in a social setup, in society, in family, in workplace, in neighborhood, anywhere, if you want to build relationships, if you want people to acknowledge you and to you know, consider you worthy or whatever it is, you need to sell yourself. Sounds cruel, no? Why should I sell myself? I'm not a commodity. Sadly, you are. Whenever I tell people that all relationships, including the so-called close and loving relationships, are also something like a business transaction, people, in fact, not only disagree, they get angry with me. What do you mean by saying business transaction? How can I have a business transaction with my loved ones, my family members, and all that? So when I say business transaction, I'm not talking about transfer of money. But when I say business transaction, what I'm talking about is there has to be a give and take. Now, what is it that you give and what is it that you want to take in this current situation that we are talking about? We want not to be taken for granted, right? This is what I want from the other person or persons. I want recognition, acknowledgement, appreciation. This is what I'm looking for. So it's like walking into a shop and saying, I want to buy A, B, C, 3 goods. So once you know that this is what I want, in a business transaction, what is the complementary to that? You have to shell out money, or you have to give some other product or services in return. Or you have to open a credit account and say that, okay, I will be paying this with interest and things of that sort. Or you issue a post-rated check or whatever you do. But the basic point remains that you have to give something and then you get something. So when you want that other people should acknowledge you, appreciate you, even if they're very close to you, you still have to sell yourself. You have to ask this question, am I selling myself properly or not? There's a very old proverb in Hindi which used to be repeated to us, whose English equivalent is, even a mother does not feed a baby till he cries, they say. The baby cries and then the mother realizes that the baby is hungry and then the mother feeds the baby. If the baby does not cry, the mother is busy, she's got 10 other things to do. She presumes that the baby is not hungry. Now, if the baby were to lie down and say, what a cruel mother, doesn't she know that so many hours have gone past and I need my fill and things of that sort? It doesn't work out that way, no? The same thing happens when you grow up and in adult life. Are you willing to cry for what you want, which in other words I told you as, are you willing to sell yourself? Now, what does any salesman do? He convinces you that he has a good product or good services to offer to you. Only if you are convinced, you will take the next step forward of saying, okay, what is the price? What is the discount? What is the guarantee? What is the installments that I'm getting, all that comes later. At a first level, you have to get convinced that this product or this service is indeed useful to me. Somebody brings something. I remember the other day I had gone to get a new pair of specs. And this lady, over-enthusiastic sales girl, immediately started off by saying, sir, we have this blue tinted thing. You know, when you work for long hours on the computer, you get that glare of the computer light and all that sort of thing. I listened to her for 60 seconds and then I said, I don't work on the computer. I'm not a computer guy. So suddenly she was deflated. Then she says, so we have this photochromatic, when you go out in the sun, you get this automatic shade coming in and that protects your eyes and something of that sort. I said, firstly, I don't go out at all, hardly during the daytime. Secondly, I said, tell me, where is the sun in a city like Bangalore? We crave for sunlight and we don't get sunlight for months together. And you're trying to tell me that you want to sell photochromatic lenses to me. She wouldn't give up. Sir, this particular little more expensive lens, is scratch proof. I said, in so many years and decades that I've been wearing specs, I don't remember when I last scratched my lenses. I'm not into that type of environment. I'm not into that type of work. And I protect my glasses. I don't think they're going to get scratched for that. Why should I pay money? Now, why am I telling you this story? To help you to understand that here is a very poor sales. If she doesn't get results, she will probably say, see, my customers are taking me for granted. I'm making so much effort, but they're not understanding me. They're not giving me custom, or they're not allowing me to sell my goods. But you know where she missed out? She missed out on understanding the customer. All she had to do was to say, sir, what type of work do you do? Do you work in the computer? Are you an outdoors person? Do you do some rough and tumble work or something of the sort? If I told her that this is the type of lifestyle I lead or this is the type of work I do, she could have immediately responded and said, for your type of working, this would be an ideal thing, that sort of thing. So we have to start off by selling yourself. You have to be assertive. I'm not saying that be proud or boast or go on, you know, announcing from rooftops, but simply, gently, but firmly tell people, this is what I am capable of. These are my good qualities, or this is what I can give to you, because everybody, finally, it boils down to, what am I getting from this person? That's what I said. Why I said relationships are like a business transaction. If I'm not getting anything from this person, I would rather not interact with that person. Sad, but true. The other area that you need to think of is the type of personality that you project. Many of us have what I refer to as invisible personality. If somebody walks into a room where 10 people are sitting, and if you are one of those whom this person just, you know, glances over and doesn't even give you a second look, that means there is something in your body image, there is something in your personality which doesn't attract people, which doesn't appeal to people. So you need to understand that even from the physical point of view, you need to project yourself to others. You need to be different in some way. You need to stand out in a crowd. Only then people pay attention to you, they remember you, and they give significance to you. They don't take you for granted. But if you are just a conformist who lives like anybody else, that's it. You will be taken for granted. Now, some of us have an advantage that we have an impressive personality physically. For such people, it is easy not to be taken for granted. But not all of us have that type of personality. If your personality is very subdued, you are a very quiet, small, thin, you know, that sort of a very soft type of a person, then you have to put in that extra effort to see that, you know, you stand out. The third thing is that if you make yourself too available, then people take you for granted. If they know that they can get anything done from you at any time, even a simple thing like chatting up. If you have friends who say that anytime I can call up Ali and he, whatever he is doing, is not that type of a busy or an important person. I know that if I call up and I just feel like chatting, he will chat with me. Normally, you would say that that's a very good quality. No, people will appreciate that and say, oh, what a nice person. Whenever I call him, you know, he's available. He gives me time. But the sad part is human behavior research that they look down upon the person and say, oh, Ali's got nothing better to do. That's why he talks to me whenever I call him up. These are realities of life. You have to face it. This is the way we are brought up. This is how society and, you know, interpersonal transactions are done on a regular basis. So once in a while, even if you're giving time to the person, you have to again assert yourself and say, right now I wanted to complete some important work. I was just in the middle of that. But since you said that you want to talk to me, you are important to me, So I'm postponing that work. I'll stay up tonight probably a little late and complete the work, but I am willing to talk to you. Now that person starts valuing your time and de facto valuing yourself. Okay, there's also a situation where people will take you for granted or try to, you know, negate you because they're jealous of you. Remember that also. Somewhere if the person feels threatened by you, somewhere if the person feels you are better than him, or you will get more popularity, or you will get more, you know, appreciation and this and that, this person will make it a habit to try and push you into the corner, take you for granted, see that none of your skills or your good points keep coming up, so that others also follow suit. That is another sad part of human temperament. Many people only blindly follow the others. See, in a typical informal discussion or conversation taking place, if 1, 2, 3 people in a sequence say something bad about someone or something, numbers 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 immediately start nodding their head because they don't want to be the odd man out. They don't want to be left out. They don't want to be questioned. They don't have the desire to prove themselves to the others. So it's far easier to acknowledge what they are saying and be part of the crowd. That is what happens if there are people who are jealous of you and they start taking you for granted. They will make sure that others also will take you for granted. Okay, so far so good. Another couple of very important points before we go to the remedy part of it. If the person knows that you do not retaliate, there's always this thing called the pecking order. You know, you always dominate over those who are not going to hit you back. That is how it happens in life. So when a person knows that you are not going to question him, why are you taking me for granted? Why aren't you giving me significance? When I have done this for you, I'm expecting reciprocation. If you are so soft that you don't do it, you don't retaliate, you don't clarify, you don't, you know, emphasize in front of others that, see, this is what I'm doing, then the person will definitely take you for granted. If he's competing with you for something, and if the relationship is deteriorating because of certain things that you have done and you have not even realized it. And that is when the person also thinks, instead of fighting with this person, instead of arguing, let me just take him for granted. Let him be there on the periphery of my social interactions and all that. But I will never give importance to what he says. I will not acknowledge. When he starts talking, I will interrupt and change the topic to something else, or I will pay my attention to a third person rather than listening to him. All these things start off. And finally, there's one more category of persons who take you for granted, which is what I mentioned right in the beginning. People who are so self-centered that they don't even realize that you have to give significance to others. You are there, you are there, fine. You are my brother, you are my this, you are my colleague, you are my whatever you are. So what? Finally, I am focused on myself. I don't care. I don't necessarily have to be good to you. So these are the type of things that happen. Now, how can you overcome this thing? What do you do when you're feeling so upset and irritated that people are continuously taking me for granted? Or even one important person in your life is taking you for granted. Everybody else is fine with you. But there's this one person who you consider important, or with whom you have such a close bond that you have to be around that person for long periods of the day and things of that sort. And that person is taking you for granted. Obviously, your life is getting affected. So, how do we overcome that? First and simple thing is, don't be nice all the time. You cannot please anyone all the time, and you should not. Once in a while, do things to irritate him so that he wakes up and says, oh, this guy can be bad to me also. He starts valuing you. It's a very cruel statement that I'm making, but I'm telling you it works. And that's the only way you're. So stop being nice to the person. Stop being obliging him all the time. as an extension of that, start being very nice in his presence to somebody else. I told you that jealousy factor. Go out of the way to please somebody else who is not taking you for granted. Let this person understand that you have a desire to do good, to build warm relationship, but you're not doing it with him, you're doing it with somebody else. If this person is very dominating, like that husband, the cartoon that you saw in the beginning, you know, wife has come back after a hard day's work and the husband just says, you know, go out and get me some bottles of beer because I'm watching this game on TV or something of that sort. Do not allow the person to override you. And when you say no, don't give excuses. So this lady, if she looks straight into the eyes of the husband and says, not now, I'm tired, I don't want to go out. And she walks into the bedroom and does whatever she wants. That is when the person realizes that I cannot take her for granted. Same way, talk about some of your skills, achievements. Now, this lady who works very hard in the office and comes back, does she spend time once in a while? I'm not saying you do it on a regular basis, but once in a while say that, you know what I do over there? I am the so-and-so in such and such department, or this responsibility is there and I do this work and there are so many people who depend on me, or I'm a team leader of so many people, or anything of that sort. So make other people understand that you have certain skills, you have certain responsibilities, you have certain achievements, which is finally what, goes back to what I told you, that even a mother doesn't give milk to a child unless the child cries. Then you could either build new skills, which will get you recognition. When you realize that people admire only when somebody does it, it could be a simple thing like your physical image. If you're a person who likes to dress very casually and very simply, people take you for granted in the physical sense. So could you, if you're okay with it, change your way of dressing so that your dressing attracts the attention of people. The way you talk, sometimes you assert yourself and say certain things which people immediately get up and take notice of. Express those sort of things. Build up a few skills or something of that sort. And whenever somebody else, you know, does not take you for granted or acknowledges you, thank him profusely and say, yes, you are the one who has understood me well. I'm so happy that you are doing this. So the person who's taking you for granted will feel bad and will realize that he has to change. Continue your work and routine to show that you are not affected when this person is taking you for granted. Make others talk on your behalf. And as I told you very clearly, do not allow yourself to feel guilty. Now that we are touching the halfway mark, before I take a very short break and start responding to the comments or the questions in the chat box, please start adding. I have a few already. We'll add on more to that. You're welcome to do that. But before I do that, can I give you a very simple tip? If you feel you're being taken for granted and you don't want to be taken for granted, get a pet. Think about it.
Hi, so in Banjara, like you know, we do a lot of programs. So some are in our classroom, and this year, because of the pandemic, thanks to the pandemic, we've gone online on a lot of programs. So I just wanted to quickly update you about the upcoming programs that we are going to be conducting. So the first one, which is starting on 29th of this month, which is a Friday. So three consecutive Fridays, we are going to do a program on career counseling. So this is going to be a program to help you, to help somebody else, you know, choose their career. So it's going to be very informative. And again, Dr. Ali will take us through that. So for any information on this, it's got nominal, you know, fee for a three session program. So it will be happening thrice on three consecutive Fridays. So this is something that will be very, very useful as a significant adult to help out, you know, the youngsters. This is one. The next one, the very next day on 30th of Jan, we are having a classroom session on sex education at home, teaching sex education at home. So this is the workshop. You can see the poster. And this is going to be a classroom right here in our training house at RT Nagar. So people in Bangalore can come and register for this. And this is a sensitive topic. So, you know, face to face would be good, a session which is here. So you can make use of this also. Please come, and this will give you, again, very good insights into how to start sex education at home right from the time your you know, kids are really small. So this is something that's going to be useful again. And we have a small little retreat called Manthan that is near Delhi Public School North. So people who are here again in Bangalore, please come for this particular workshop. This time the topic is on relationships. So again, this you know, will be full of a lot of sessions by Dr. Ali and many other sessions which will help you to introspect relationships. So again, this we have timed it along with the Valentine's Day. So 13th and 14th of Feb. So you're again most welcome to join. Just again, very nominal charges to just take care of the upkeep of the place and the food and things like that. And it's going to be a fun-filled time. At the same time, a lot of learning, a lot of mutual learning. So you're more than welcome for that. So these are the three programs which are coming up. So I hand it over back to Dr. Ali.
Just one more point I thought I'll add before I start answering your comments and questions. When you feel, it's your feeling, isn't it, that I'm being taken for granted, I'm not being acknowledged, I'm not being appreciated, I do so much for XYZ and I don't get any returns and all that. So please understand that that is your thinking, right? You take ownership of those thoughts and those feelings that you are getting. Now, as Rupali says, at times guilt happens when we are dealing with children. Yes, I know so many mothers who get very angry with the child, even give him a whack or something, or, you know, shout at the child and they burst out crying. They get more upset. Now, the child presumes that because you are crying and you are saying sorry, that means you know that what you have done is wrong. So child becomes even more dominating and even more rebellious. This is what I mean by saying, then the same mother will say that, see, I'm being taken for granted by my children. They don't listen to me. So even if you have done something wrong, as in, let's say, giving a whack to your child, apologize for giving a whack, saying that I lost control over myself when I hit you. I shouldn't have done that. That's not the way to deal with the situation. But nonetheless, I feel what you have done is wrong and you should be punished for it. I will not allow you to do these sort of things which are not acceptable. Winter said, when people know you are good and capable of something, they tend to dump it on you and make you do it, both at the workplace. Is that being taken? Yes, absolutely, Winter, you're right. You people take you for granted because they know that you are good and you are not going to say. That's why one of the first points that I said, as far as dealing with this is concerned, is don't be nice all the time. Don't oblige. If you find that one person or some people are dumping all their work on you, once in a while, even if you're free, even if you're inclined to do that work, just don't. And added to that, I told you, no, don't give excuses. Don't start saying, no, I have some other work. No, not right now and all that. Just say, sorry, no, I can't do that. That's it. End of the thing. Meena says, relatives and friends, they just like to pile on my home and life for days together. I'm aware that they are taking me for granted. It's a very uncomfortable situation. I would have to tell them to leave so that I can just be happy and relax mentally. How do I approach this situation? There's a very nice Bollywood movie recently where there's this young couple in UK or wherever, and the mama and mommy, you know, land up over there and start making themselves very comfortable in the house and all that they go through. It's brought out very well. But finally, what it boils down to is that, am I being assertive enough? Can I tell people, let's say somebody has walked in, an elder person, and you can't say no to him. You can tell the person, oh, I'm so happy that you have come here on 23rd, because 25th onwards, I'm not going to be available. So I would like you to make the best of the next 2 days that you are here. And also let me know where I can drop you off on 24th evening, because I'll arrange the vehicle and something of that sort. No, we wanted to stay longer. I also wish you would have stayed longer, but it's not possible, no? Because 25th onwards, I'm not available. I am not available. As I told you, the trick lies in not giving excuses, not asking for permission, or not feeling guilty or anything of that sort. How do we give ourselves more importance and not feel guilty about it, as we have always been taught to put others first? You're absolutely right, Anshu. That is where our self-esteem has to be built up. If we feel that, we have been taught like this, that, you should always be nice to others, you should be nice to elders, you should be nice to so-and-so, whatever it may be. We have to start breaking that vicious cycle. It's a process by itself. I'm not going into the details now, but believe me, you can do it. If you set your mind and say, these guests keep coming and landing up in my house and they do this, or my relatives take me for granted, or my people in my office take me for granted. If you make up your mind, there are very wonderful tips and techniques, how to be assertive, how to learn to say no, how to build up your own self-esteem and self-worth to say that even if these people get angry with me and say nasty things to me, it's not going to affect me. Anupama says, in a relationship, in case both parties start taking each other for granted and that leads to further misunderstanding. Yeah, both are taking each other for granted, then the relationship itself is deteriorating. So you don't really have to deal with the situation. I'm taking X for granted and X is taking me for granted. So basically, we don't need each other. So we are drifting apart. Even if we are so close to each other that we live in the same family or the same house or whatever it is, we can still live without having too much of emotional attachment or too much of acknowledgement or appreciation of each other. It's only when it is one-sided when things get difficult. So like Vinita said, sorry, I wanted to know, sometimes we are aware that we are taken for granted, but still we remain quiet due to situation, relationship, and we don't do anything. Now, what is this situation or this relationship because of which we don't do anything? You need to ask yourself. No situation, no relationship is more important than you yourself. You are not going to subjugate yourself and say, oh, the situation is such. I told you a simple thing, like you have been brought up to respect your elders. Oh, they are my elders. How can I say this? There are ways and means of dealing with elders. You can be very nice to them. You can take care of their needs. When there is a need, please understand the difference between needs and wants. You may have an elder who has a need. The person has to get medical treatment, or the person has to have some food, which is without oil or without sugar or something of that sort. That's a need because the doctors have said it. Yes, you oblige them. But if that person says that I want you to make 5 dishes for me, or want you to make dessert for me or something of that sort, that's a want. That's not a need. Just because the person is important or elder or something, you don't have to keep obliging. All you have to say is, I'm making this for you, but I'm not making the dessert today. Why? What happened? No, today I will not be able to make the dessert, but I'm busy. I'm making the food. I hope you like the food, etc. Keep going back like a broken record. Emphasizing that this is what I will do and this is what I will not do. There's always an emotional baggage of blackmail that actually makes us do things even when we don't want to. Yes, that baggage, that emotional baggage is what pulls down our self-esteem or makes us feel guilty. And therefore, we want to redeem ourselves. Because in the past, I've done something wrong, or in the past, I've hurt somebody, or in the past, I've been criticized when I've not gone out of the way to do things. So I will do it. No, you have to get rid of your past. A lot of things depend on baggage. You use the right word. The emotional baggage that we carry into the present from yesterday. whatever your stage of life, whatever your age, whatever else you are doing, please get rid of any emotional baggage that you are carrying, which you built when you were 3 years old or 13 years old or 39 years old. Make conscious efforts to get rid of it, not only for this issue of being taken for granted, but for basic quality of life also. Does having a weak boundary also invite other people to take you for granted? Yes. You have to build that Lakshman Rekha around you and say, this close and no further. This much I will do, but I will not step out of that and do something further and beyond that. Initially, people will criticize you. People will label you. People will say you are very selfish and self-centered. They'll use all those type of words to make you feel guilty. But if you decide that I'm not going to feel guilty, I know that I am doing my duty. I know that I'm there for the person whenever he or she needs me. But I'm not going to go out of the way to do things. Let that person feel bad. Because if the you keep obliging, then the person keeps taking you for granted. How to be guilt-free when you walk off a grated relationship? Rationalize. List down what are the reasons why you're walking off from this relationship. This relationship has become toxic. This relationship is not getting me what I want. This relationship has become one-sided. This relationship is hurting me. This relationship is hurting my other relationships. I want to focus on people who are good to me. So I'm not just walking off from this relationship. I'm walking towards other good relationships. How to handle an abusive parent? It could be anybody. I was just mentioning elders. Obviously, the parents are the most significant elders. Again, I come back to the same thing. You abuse me and I'm going to have a cold war with you. I just turn around and look at you. You say something very nasty to me. I turn around with a neutral expression. Just 10 seconds I look at you to say that this is I'm disapproving, not utter a word, and continue doing what you want. Next time the person talks nicely to you, go very close with a big smile, give a hug or whatever, and say, hey, I'm so happy that you mentioned this, or you asked this. Thing, I feel proud of you and I'm going to do it. The carrot and stick policy, where they say no. So you have this parent who's taking you for granted, who's dumping everything onto you. But when the parent realizes that when he is abusive to you, you are not going to be doing things for him. But when he is not abusive to you, you're going to go out of the way and do things for him. Slowly, it takes time, it takes effort, it takes patience, consistence. But over a period of time, it works in most cases. Now, you may have a very, very cruel parent or somebody who's, you know, literally a tyrant. That is when you have to really think about your relationship and see how you can insulate yourself. Children at the age of 20 plus also take their parents for granted. Why? Because those 20 years, you allowed them to take you for granted. Ma, I'm watching TV. Get me some coffee. Beta, I also want to watch TV. Most of the days I'm making coffee. Today, why don't you make coffee for both of us? I'll tell you what you missed out on the TV program. Simple things like that. Or I will make the coffee, but after I finish with the TV program or after I do this sort of thing. So if you do that in the first 20 years, then 20 plus, they will not take advantage of you. But that's a mistake. That's why I keep reminding you and keep coming back to the one important point that please look inward. Don't say that my child who has grown up now is misbehaving and taking me for granted and not reciprocating to me and things of that sort, because you have contributed to it. And why I'm asking you to do it is not to regret and not to sit and feel guilty or whatever it is, but to tell yourself that since I have contributed towards this situation, I will have to work to improve the situation and get it back on track. So nothing lost. My child is an adult and has grown up and has now taken me for granted. Slowly my behavior will change towards the child. And I will assert, I will show the child that this is what I have done and this is what I am doing. And this is what I expect from you. Bharti says, people who receive most from us take us more for granted. That's exactly what I've been telling. the more you keep obliging, the higher their expectation grows, and then they start wondering, you know, what is wrong? Why is this person not obliging? I don't know whether I had mentioned this little, you know, parable or story that there was this beggar who used to go shouting in one lane from one end to the other, saying that, you know, I'm hungry, give me food or something. There was one lady in that lane who somehow used to make it a point to give food to him, whatever they have, even if little bit is left over or something or the other. But she would see to it that something, some food is given to him. There was another lady at the end of the lane who not only never gave him any food or money, but she would put her head out of the window and scream at him and say, why are you shouting and disturbing everybody? Why are you coming and begging? Go and do work. And she would close the window. That went on for days and days and days. One fine day, the first lady was going through some crisis. There was absolutely no food in her house, not even for her to eat, forget about the beggar. So when this man came and stood in front of the gate and was shouting, she very sincerely apologized and said, "Yeah, there is no food today. Something, Ma, give something, Amma, what is this?" And no, there is absolutely no food for you. He went away. He kept shouting. He reached the end of the lane, and that lady who had never given him any food, she had some leftover or something of that sort. She saw his empty plate, and with a grumpy face, she came and dumped that food into his plate and said, "Take it." And you know what this man said? "Amma, you are an angel of mercy. You have rescued me. Today I was in such a bad position. I would have starved today. You know why? Because that stupid woman on whom I am relying, I know that at least some food I will get every day. And without warning, she ditched me. What a horrible woman she is. She didn't think what is going to happen to me. And just like that, today she said, 'Go, I'm not giving you.' It is because of you. You are an angel. You are so nice that today you gave me food." Sounds ridiculous, no? But that's what happens. That's exactly what human behavior is, all these things. What we are reminded of the past again and again, the person who keeps reminding you of the past, try to insulate yourself from that person. If you can physically tell him, "Sorry, I don't want to keep talking about the past. Let's talk about the present. You have issues with me. I'm willing to listen to you, but I don't want to hear what I did last month, last year, 10 years back. If you can't do that and the person just goes up and on with it, insulate yourself mentally by stopping to either listen to the person or stopping to get affected by the person saying that this has become a temperament. This is the way this person has taken me for granted and goes on with that. But I am not going to get affected by it because I know. Sometimes it even helps to go and talk to somebody else and say, X is telling me day in and day out about what happened in the past. What do you feel about it? You've also been associated with me for a long time. And if that person says, no, I consider you as a good person. I've enjoyed whatever interaction and relationship you have. It counters what this first person is trying to pull you down. Smita says, many times we don't even understand we are being taken for granted, but only after a long period of time when we are unable to handle, we'll realize what is happening with us. You're absolutely right, Smita. That happens because we are not, you know, giving importance to ourselves, our self-worth. So here is this person taking us for granted, making us do things, ignoring us when he doesn't need us and all that. And we think this is what it is because my self-worth itself is low. If that has happened once and you have now become aware of it, please work towards protecting yourself in future. It should never happen now that you have realized that once I've gone through this thing of being taken for granted for days and years without even realizing it, I'm not going to make the same mistake again. Viva says, boundaries are so important, right? Initially, it is difficult and conflict and emotional blackmail is there. That's what protects us from being assertive, and that's what protects us and prevents us from asking for what we want. Oh, this person will get angry. He's a very short-tempered person. If I say this, he'll start shouting at me. He'll point out so many mistakes of mine. The moment we start thinking about that short-term conflict or the short-term negativity that is going to come, we are losing out on the long-term benefits. So you say, it's okay. He will shout. I know it. That's his temperament. He will put me down. He will say nasty things. But for how long? If I continue to be assertive, if I continue to remind my worth, and if I continue to not oblige him all the time, if I continue to assert and show that I am also a worthy person, and unless and until my worth is acknowledged by you, I am not going to be nice to you. Unless we do that, the person is not going to change. We need to be taught all these relationships right from a young age. Parenting classes should be mandatory. Nobody's going to make it mandatory, but let's not dream of a utopian society. But yes, we can do it within our circles. We can do it for ourselves. That's why we run this CCAD course, no? Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development. Understand children, understand adolescent from 0 to 18. What are their needs? What are not their needs? From both angles. So that we should not take them for granted. We should not allow their self-esteem to go down so that they don't know how to assert themselves. And similarly, they should not start taking their parents, elders, and other people for granted, thinking that I'm such a great guy. I can do whatever I want in this world. Then, yeah, givers need to establish boundaries because takers seldom do. I agree with Surekha, absolutely. We need to establish boundaries when you are giving to people. Tell that I would like to do this. It's a little inconvenient, but since you are important to me, I'm still doing it. I have this other activity to do, or I would have rather sat down and watched my favorite TV program. But I will do this and then I will do that. So whenever you are doing something good, one is, Surekha said, set boundaries. In the same breath, also, as I said, sell yourself. Tell the people that this is what I am, doing that. Yes, Navina, we have to, you know, point out that I am not easily available. I told you, no, sometimes even if you're available, make it a point to say that I'm not available. You may just want to go and lock yourself in the room and listen to music and lie down or something. You may like to go out for a walk. You may like to just sit and chat with friends or play computer games or whatever you want to do. You don't have to give excuses. You don't have to give details. Tell the person, I'm not available right now. I can't do this at present. You have done it so many times. Oh, I'm so happy that you acknowledge that I've done it so many times. But this time, right now, I'm not in a position to do it. No excuses, no feeling guilty, no giving long explanations, no giving further promises also. Not even to say, yeah, tomorrow I will definitely do it. Tomorrow that fellow is going to catch hold of you. What I tell in even money transactions, no? If somebody wants a loan from you and if you say, no, I don't have the money, you know, it's already 24th of the month, where I'll have money. Okay, I'll come on first and collect it from you. Now, it's almost as though you owe him money on the first. Not that he is asking for a loan from you. So he's taken you for granted because you are the one who's giving excuses. You are the one who's feeling guilty. You are the one who's trying to give elaborate explanations when there is no need to give. Person is taking you for granted, wanting you to do things, refusing to do anything for you. Fine, that is you. I tried. And try once, twice, three times, four times, five times. But if I realize that you are not going to change, then I am going to change. My behavior with you will not be the same as it was earlier. At the same time, don't forget what I told you. The moment the person is good to you, oblige. Let the person feel the difference that when the person does not take you for granted, when the person reciprocates, when the person appreciates, when the person also does gestures, the person can get much more out of you. So from a selfish point of view also, he will start acknowledging you and appreciating you and things of that sort. See, most of us people who are a little soft, who are a little kind, compassionate, those are the type of people who are generally taken for granted. It is nothing to do with your abilities or your inabilities. It is to do with what you are projecting yourself as. That's why I told you right in the beginning. that are you selling yourself? Are you projecting? Do people even know that you are capable of doing this? Do people even know that you are tired when you come back home from office and you would like to relax? Do people know that you have your own emotional needs? You need people to appreciate a homemaker who cooks hours together in the kitchen. Does she get even a word of compliment? She just keeps cooking. When something is bad, they immediately shout. That's what we saw in the beginning, no? That when they have a need, then you immediately become a very important person. Hey, what is this? There's no salt in this sabzi, and why have you not made chapati? You've only made rice and something. It starts off. It's okay if they have loved ones, if they are part of family. They have a right to say that. Provided the flip side, when you do something nice, they don't take it for granted that it was your duty to cook nice food or extra food or whatever it is. They should learn to appreciate. And who is going to teach them to appreciate? It has to be you. It is your need. Don't forget that. I inevitably keep reminding people that when you have a need for something, don't keep giving excuses. Don't keep running behind others and say, however much I try, that person doesn't change. That person doesn't do. Have you changed? Have you started behaving in a different manner so that the other person sits up and takes notice and says, yes, I need to do something about this. Naveena is absolutely right. I think when we value ourselves and realize how important we are and express it in words and action, simple word, no boasting, no putting the other person down, but just telling that this is what it is. I love all of you in the family. That's why I go out of the way to cook. Today I was tired. I think I was running slight temperature also. I had to take a paracetamol, but I said that no, I'll go into the kitchen and I'll cook. Maybe it will tire me out. In that case, evening, we'll just have leftovers or we can order food from outside. These are the ways and means by which you can help people not to take you for granted. Keep this in mind. And there are so many other things that you can do. Our objective is from time to time, give you that little nudge, wake you up a little bit here and there, make you sit up and think about certain things so that there's a constant endeavor, a constant, you know, striving towards not only improving your own quality of life, but also improving your relationships, directly or indirectly helping others around you also to learn certain skills. So when they learn that they can't take you for granted, they will not take somebody else for granted who may retaliate very badly. So in that way, you are also helping those people. Keep working on it. Have a wonderful weekend. And as always, we shall meet next Saturday at 11 o'clock. And those of you who are interested, we have these in between different types of workshops, which Seema has given you all the details. Join us for whatever you feel like and get in touch with us if you want any help, any, you know, guidance, any free counseling. If you know somebody else who needs, please keep referring. As you know, we offer free counseling and it's a pleasure to reach out to people. Thank you very much. And bye-bye.
Thank you.